You want me to
put... Oh, yeah, it's fine. Yeah.
It's okay?
Yeah, you're fine. How are you? How are you doing?
Good to see you. I need to mic up.
Ah, poor Andrew. You're the walking wounded, man.
Chasing a two-year-old.
Yeah, that's. I think that's what the stress fracture is from.
Hits you every time.
Hits you every time.
That's pretty good.
Get that on your own.
Okay. All right. You guys ready? Okay. Hey, good afternoon. I know we received a lot of inquiries today, so we thought we would gather in one spot and maybe I'd be able to answer your questions about what we know. And maybe I'll start with just a brief statement. I'm Darrell Steinberg, the mayor of Sacramento. You know, to me, there are two very clear parts of this that I want to distinguish and differentiate. Number one is Sacramento is going to do everything it can to care for these vulnerable people who are dropped off at our doorsteps. No matter what the terrible motivation was from whoever did this, that's our job. This is a city of immigrants. It's a city of refugees. It has the city and the region has one of the largest Afghan refugee populations in the country. We've taken in Ukrainian immigrants and we've taken in immigrants from all over the country. And it speaks to our values. Statue of Liberty says, give us your tired, your poor, and your huddled masses. And Sacramento always works to live up to that ideal. And so when this occurred on Saturday and today, what I'm most proud of is the fact that our community-based organizations, our city, our county, obviously our governor who leads in every way here, the attorney general, we have been working together over the last 48 plus hours to make sure that first and foremost, that the people who are scared, who are vulnerable, who are flown here under some lure of jobs and or services, that they know that they are safe and that they will be well cared for. And we will follow through whatever is best for them, whether it's reconnection with family in the region or the country, whether it's helping them resettle, whatever it is, we will help them. That's one part of it. The other part, and I would call that, and that's the best of American values. That's what Americans do when people are hurting, when they are vulnerable. And then there's the other side of this, which is the worst of American values. And that is somebody, and the early evidence points to Florida, and we know where that points, who would use innocent, vulnerable people as political pawns. Is there no shame, as someone once said during the McCarthy era, it doesn't matter what your political viewpoint is on immigration. We all know there needs to be comprehensive federal immigration reform. And that, you know, since John McCain was in the Senate, there have not been many vocal people on the other side of the aisle who have said, let's make this a national priority. But it doesn't matter what your point of view is on immigration. What matters is the tactic of using the most vulnerable people as your political pawn. Anyone who does that is not worth dignifying. And so we speak out loudly against the perpetrators here. And by the way, I'm very pleased that the Attorney General and the Governor are calling for a criminal investigation. I'm not a criminal lawyer, but you know, if you do lure people under false pretenses to and fly them to another state across state lines, I don't know what that is, whether it's kidnapping, whether it's some other crime, but it certainly ought to be fully investigated. And whoever is responsible ought to be held accountable for this. And so we live in a tale of two stories here. And, you know, I know people say, well, this represents the political divide in the country. Well, maybe, but I think and I know that the vast majority of Americans, regardless of their political point of view, do not believe that it is right to essentially take vulnerable people, put them on a plane, and fly them to a place where they know no one, where they're scared, where they're vulnerable, just so you can score points with your primary voters or whatever other motivation you might have. And so we control what we can control. What we control is how we act. And we're going to act in the only way that Sacramento knows, and that is to embrace, welcome, and help the people.
Mayor Steinberg, can you talk about when you were made aware that the flight was coming in from Florida over the weekend, and when you were made aware that the flight was coming in from Texas today? And when you heard that, when you became aware that these were migrants who were just essentially dumped off here in California, what was your reaction? Who do you call in that moment to kind of like figure out the game plan?
I became aware on Saturday, probably around noontime, that the first plane had arrived. And I immediately connected with the governor's office. I connected with the city leadership and connected with the nonprofit organization, Sacramento ACT, who I know today. I was in my office working on other matters, and I heard mid-morning about the second plane, and you know, repeated the same, largely the same exercise. But you know, the thing about it is that this community does not need me to spring into action here. It's reflexive in Sacramento, and that gives me such pride that the community-based organizations, the city, the county, the state, we all know each other. We've been through, if not this, similar things before, and we go into action, and that's exactly what happened on Saturday. I know I went down to where the people were on Saturday, and the people were in interviews with the Department of Justice, so I didn't get to meet them, but I did have a chance to thank some of the people who were helping them. I have not had that same chance today yet, but I'm just proud of the way this community instinctively knows what to do when anybody is a victim or anybody is treated badly because of who they are.
Mayor, are you expecting more?
I don't know. I mean, I think it's probably a reasonable expectation, but we don't know. And so we'll be prepared. We will be prepared.
Mayor, can you talk about the resources that are being provided to the first group of people and potentially the second group of people?
Well, I know that initially the Catholic Diocese, where they were brought off at least with the first plane load on Saturday, that they stepped up right away. I know that the interfaith community is stepping up in a major way. The city and county are working together with the state, determining, you know, what is needed, what's needed beyond the first couple of days in terms of housing, what's needed in terms of food, what is needed in terms of legal assistance for people. And all of that is, you know, it's all hands on deck, as it should be. But it's very much centered on each individual, what they need and what we need to do to make sure that they're safe, that they feel safe, and that they are going to get cared for in the way that any of us, if we landed in another city not knowing anyone, would hope and expect that we would be treated.
To that point, can you speak to sort of the mindset or feelings that you witnessed when you met up with the group of migrants on Saturday?
I didn't actually meet them. I want to be clear. I was in the place, but they were in separate interview rooms. So I did not have that chance yet, Melanie.
Some of the interpreters, some of the people who are the first responders in helping them assimilate.
Well,
have they talked to how these people are feeling? I would imagine.
Well, the reaction, what I've heard, is that they're scared, but they're also and they feel, what I've heard, is that they finally feel safe because they know that they are now in the arms of a community that cares about them and that will help them find their way, whatever their way is, we will help them.
You said early evidence maybe pointing to Florida. Like, how long would this process take? I mean,
obviously the Department of Justice here in California and the Attorney General Rob Bonta is leading the investigation. So I want to make sure, I know they spoke to the Florida connection, so I feel comfortable doing that. But in terms of more detail, they should be the ones to talk about that, because we're not the ones at the city that are conducting the investigation. Is that okay? What can I say? What a world. But always do the right thing. And that's what this community is about.
I know it happened last year, but timing-wise, with DeSantis having already announced his bid for the presidency, I mean, do you think it's coincidental timing, or, you know?
I don't know. I mean, I've read the same, you know, the same newspaper accounts that his campaign is not doing very well.
And again,
guess everybody, I don't know, but you know, there are many positive ways to get attention. People are hungry for leadership. They're hungry for leaders who bridge the divide, who bring people together. That may not be true of, you know, I guess the majority of the Republican primary electorate, but that's what the majority of the American people want. That's why, you know, despite all the great challenges, people have such great respect for Joe Biden, because he's a healer. He's a uniter. He's not a divider.
Okay.
Thank you all for your patience and for coming out at short notice. Okay.
So, Mayor, this is Tron. She's actually new to the Sacramento area.
So did you take Don's room?
I took that
wireless to this desk.
Thanks, Paul.
When I was